Hello everybody, thank you so much for tuning in to tonight's episode of What is in the Night Sky this month. I'm going to be taking you on a beautiful tour of the night sky in the month of March. We're going to visit several deep sky objects, galaxies, star clusters. We're going to see what the moon and the planets are up to. So as always, buckle in and let's see what's really out there. So for this month, we're going to start off and see what the moon and the planets are up to, and we're going to stay within our solar system because there is a cool phenomenon that will be occurring in the month of March. Neptune is in conjunction with the sun on the 17th and therefore not visible. Mercury, on the other hand, makes a strong appearance in the evening sky from around the 10th onwards. It reaches its greatest elongation on the 24th and can be seen low over the western horizon 15 minutes after sunset. Jupiter is now past its best, but still can be seen in the twilight after sunset, with a beautiful crescent moon appearing nearby on the 13th. Uranus is also losing ground against the sun, but it may be spotted about an hour after sunset. Both Jupiter and Uranus will appear within the same binocular field of view from mid-month onwards. Make the most of it, as the two will not be this close again for another 13 years. Meanwhile, in the pre-dawn twilight, Venus and Mars also appear within the same binocular field of view for the first week of March. But while Mars is moving away from Sun, Venus is slipping closer towards it. A crescent moon appears nearby on the 7th and the 8th. The moon itself turns new on the 10th and then full on the 25th. So later in the month of March, we will be witness to what is known as a penumbral lunar eclipse. Let's talk more about that. As lunar eclipses go, penumbral eclipses typically don't deliver much, but they can still be worth a see, if only to see if you can notice any difference. This month, there is a penumbral eclipse in the early hours of the 25th, with a mid-eclipse occurring at 3:14 in the morning Eastern Time. Next, we are going to move out past our solar system and way past our galaxy, and we're going to take a look at a gorgeous galaxy pair, Messier 81 and Messier 82, Bode's Galaxy and the Cigar Galaxy. Here is a close pair of galaxies that's relatively easily seen and readily observed throughout the spring. Both may be spotted with binoculars under dark skies. That being said, this isn't just for visual observers. Messier 81 and Messier 82 are beautiful galaxies for astrophotographers. You can image them individually, or you can image them with a wider field of view and catch some of that interstellar flux nebula or dust lit by the galaxy itself surrounding Messier 81 and Messier 82. This is a fine example of a galaxy pair that is perfect for those just starting out in astrophotography. Next, we are going to move on closer within our own galaxy, and we're going to view one of the most iconic open clusters in the night sky, Messier 44, the Beehive Cluster. Located in the faint constellation of Cancer, the Crab, the Beehive Cluster holds the unique distinction of being the only deep sky object that's brighter than any of the stars that make up the constellation itself. If you live under dark skies, you should be able to spot this cluster with your naked eye, but otherwise binoculars will do the trick. Even through 8x32 binoculars, the cluster takes on an elongated diamond shape with a close double appearing on the northern tip of the diamond. Telescopically, the cluster is best observed at low power, with the majority of the stars appearing blue-white, but with a few coppery stars scattered here and there. Messier 44 is fantastic through an eyepiece, but you can really bring out the colors when you photograph this star cluster. You can really see how bright and colorful the stars are compared to the fainter stars in the background. So moving on to our next deep sky object is Messier 67. This is another gorgeous open cluster. The Beehive is one of two Messier open star clusters that can be found in Cancer. M67 is conveniently located just 2 degrees west of the star Accubens, and at 4 billion years old is one of the oldest open star clusters known. We will move from Messier 67 to a double star known as Algieba. Gamma Leonis, otherwise known as Algieba, is an easy double for binoculars with a surprise for telescopic observers. Algieba is one of the stars that make up the mane of Leo the Lion. Binoculars will show a fairly wide companion, but telescopes at around 100 times will split the primary star into two beautiful golden components. Well, that is it for our tour of the night sky in the month of March. We thank you so much for tuning in. If you've ever seen any of these objects through an eyepiece or even photographed them, please let us know the equipment you used and maybe what that looked like through an eyepiece. We would love to hear your stories. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel if you have not already, because you do not want to miss any of our content on all things astronomy and astrophotography. Again, my name is Teagan. Thank you so much for tuning in, and clear skies.